Hey guys, welcome to Education Hub. So guys, today we are going to discuss one chapter from class 10th biology, and chapter is life processes. So guys, basically we have done few parts of the chapter in our 3 videos, and in today's videos we are going to discuss about human digestive system. So let's begin with the video guys.
As I have already told you that we are going to discuss about human digestive system, right? So here is the diagram with the help of which we are going to discuss the digestive system of human beings, right? So guys, see, this is your whole human digestive system, and this diagram is very important and essential for your chapter. It is because guys, this diagram is very important as it comprises of your half of life process system. It means it is the main process which carries out your digestion of food and the assimilation of food to provide you the energy. So generally बहुत सारे questions इस part से पूछे जाते हैं, so that's why I thought why not to make one video of diagram for you in which you only discuss the digestive system in human beings through the diagram. So most of the diagrams were very complicated, but this diagram I found to be very relatable to your topic, as it is all the glands and parts are mentioned in your proper way and you will easily be able to understand it. So let's see, first we will start from mouth, right? So here is your mouth. This is your mouth, and this mouth is basically your initial point for injection of food in your body, right? So it's a very important part of our human body and human digestive system. Few questions are basically arise for that, why mouth is considered in digestive system, right? Because no digestion takes place in mouth, so why it is considered as one of the digestive system part? So guys, answer of this question is that it is your initial point होता है जहाँ से हमारा food हमारी body में enter करता है, and it is also very important place for proper crushing of food, क्योंकि mouth में हमारा क्या क्या present होता है, as I have told you, saliva gland present होता है which releases your salivary amylase, right? So saliva gland क्या करता है, हमारे salivary amylase को release करता है, and this salivary amylase your helps to convert your starch into carbohydrates and further simple components, right? So इसीलिए mouth हमारा एक digestive system का part है, because it consists of your two parts, your teeth and few special glands. One of those is salivary amylase, or you can say salivary gland, right? So what your teeth do is that they properly crush the food, and this crushing of food is very important, because अगर food अच्छे से crush नहीं होगा, so you will not be able to absorb or assimilate all the nutrition present in that food, right? So इसीलिए ये बहुत important है, and that's what the reason is कि हम mouth को as a digestive part consider करते हैं, right? Now after your mouth comes your tongue, so it is considered as a part of mouth, and later your comes your pharynx. I have told you in your respiratory system में भी मैंने आपको बताया था कि your pharynx is your food and windpipe. It means जो pharynx होती है, pharynx is your same as your windpipe and same as your food pipe. But जो differentiation करता है food and windpipe में, वो है आपका epiglottis. outside. So that epiglottis is just present after your last part of your nostrils, that is your nasal cavity. Nasal cavity ke baad jo structure present hota hai yahan par ek plate like structure hota hai, and that plate like cluster is your called as what? Epiglottis. That epiglottis is very important. Agar wo absent hoga, so we will not be able to respire and eat food at the same time. Iska matlab hai ki jo epiglottis hota hai wo open rehta hai jab aap respire kar rahe hote hain. When you take in or release out the air, so aapka epiglottis open rehta hai. Something this like structure may be there, right? Some plate like structure aisa hota hoga which is attached to your windpipe. जब गैसेस एक्सचेंज होता होगा तो मे बी इट वुड बी ओपन लाइक दिस, एंड जब आप फूड खाते हो सडनली, सो दैट एपिग्लॉटिस क्लोजेज योर विंड पाइप, जिससे कि जो हमारा फूड पार्टिकल है वो डायरेक्ट विंड पाइप में ना होकर ईसोफेगस में चला जाए. ठीक है, सो ईसोफेगस इज योर दिस एरिया, राइट? सो यही होता है कि शायद इसी वजह से ये फ्लैट प्लेट लाइक स्ट्रक्चर होता है, जो कि ऑलवेज हमेशा तो ओपन रहता है, बट वेन यू ईट फूड इट क्लोजेज योर पाथवे फॉर विंड पाइप, जिससे कि फूड पार्टिकल आपके विंड पाइप में जाकर चोकिंग ना कर सके, एंड विच प्रिवेंट्स योर सफोकेशन डेथ, राइट? सो योर वन मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट फंक्शन ऑफ दिस पार्ट इज देयर. सो अगर आप डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम लिख रहे हो या रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम लिख रहे हो, सो यू हैव टू मेंशन दिस, दैट वन स्पेशल स्ट्रक्चर इज प्रेजेंट विच प्रिवेंट्स द चोकिंग ऑफ विंड पाइप व्हेन वी ईट फूड, एंड दैट स्ट्रक्चर इज कॉल्ड एज एपिग्लॉटिस, राइट? सो एपिग्लॉटिस और ईसोफेगस दे आर सिमिलर, बस ये है कि कुछ सर्टेन डिस्टेंस है जहाँ के बाद हम विंड पाइप को विंड पाइप ना बोलकर क्या बोलते हैं, ईसोफेगस, यानी कि फूड पाइप बोलते हैं. ठीक है, आफ्टर फूड पाइप कम्स योर स्टमक. दिस इज योर स्टमक. स्टमक इज योर बेसिक थिंग विच यू आर कमिंग फ्रॉम लर्निंग फ्रॉम बेसिकली योर क्लास फोर, राइट? सो स्टमक में क्या होता है कि ईसोफेगस के थ्रू सारा फूड कलेक्ट हो जाता है. आफ्टर दैट सम स्पेशल enzymes are secreted like HCl and other enzymes also. So that enzymes help in digestion of food. So जब वो थोड़ा half digested हो जाता है, so after stomach is reaches to your large intestine. Large intestine जो होता है, it's the last pathway. योर लास्ट पार्ट पे होता है. सो इसका मतलब है कि आपको ये बताना है कि जो हमारा स्टमक है, स्टमक के बाद फूड कहाँ पहुँचता है, स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन में, राइट? स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन में फूड पहुँचता है तो वहाँ पर काफ़ी हाई सिक्रीशन होते हैं एंजाइम्स के, जैसे कि पैनक्रियाज से पैनक्रियाटिक जूस स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन में जूस रिलीज होते हैं, दैट इज इंटरस्टिशियल जूसेस और एंजाइम्स, राइट? So these are a lot of enzymes are secreted in small intestine, and in this small intestine your proper digestion of food takes place, and it is the only site where your assimilation yani ki absorption ka process bhi hamara kisme hota hai, small intestine mein hota hai, right? So your absorption process is very important because in these small intestine your very small single leg projections are present, and that single leg projections are called as villi. You must have read in class 9th and 10th, right? So these villi are very important structures which are present in your small intestine, and what they do, their function is very important because they increase your surface area for absorption of food. It means that these villi increase the absorption rate of digested food, right? So बहुत ही millions में छोटे छोटे structures होते हैं कि it is very difficult to see them with your naked eyes, right? So these are very important structures कि small intestine में present होते हैं, and they increase the rate of absorption of digested food, right? right? And after your small intestine comes at last your large intestine. This large intestine is your last part for digestive system. As I told you before also, this is your last pathway, and this is the area where your undigested food or waste material is reabsorbed again. जो भी हमारा residual part बचा होता है small intestine से absorption के बाद, वो कहाँ जाता है? Large intestine में. And reaching after reaching this area, this is your large intestine outer area. This is area again reabsorbs those food particles which were absorbed in small intestine. So इसका क्या मतलब है कि जो large intestine में again क्या होता है? Assimilation, यानी कि reabsorption का process होता है, right? So these reabsorption process ensures that there is no, or you can say even not very small amount of nutrition left over in the digestive system. और इसी small intestine में आपका क्या होता है? H2O का absorption भी होता है, जिससे कि body को जो भी H2O ज़्यादा चाहिए हो at the time of digesting food, so that is also used. And after the use of your water, your excess amount of water is removed as a form of urine through your excretory system, right? So ye to tha hamara large intestine. And after large intestine, your last part is your anus. That anus is connected through your large intestine, through where your waste products are removed from your body. Removal of waste products from body is also very essential, guys, because there is a lot of toxic materials present in the waste products of body. So that's what the reason is that in summers we get sweating, right? In summers we get sweating and there is a lot of salt and excess water removed from our body. That, so it is very important to removal of body waste. As you know, few people go on dialysis when their kidney fails, right? So due to the kidney fail, there is the problem in the person that the purification of water and urine does not take place. तो अगर वाटर और यूरिन का अच्छे से प्योरिफिकेशन नहीं होगा तो क्या होगा? सो देयर विल बी प्रॉब्लम ऑफ नॉन रिमूवल ऑफ टॉक्सिक गैसेस. तो सो दैट्स व्हाट द रीजन इज दैट पर्सन हैज टू गो फ्रॉम द पेनफुल प्रोसेस ऑफ डायलिसिस टू दिस प्रोसेस एक्चुअली थ्रू द टेक्निकल मशीन, एडवांस मशीन. योर बॉडी ब्लड इट्स प्योरिफाइड एंड योर यूरिन इज रिमूव फ्रॉम योर बॉडी, right? So that is the dialysis process, and same as the removal of toxins from the body is very essential. But between your large intestine and your anus comes one more important structure, and that very important, you should know the name of that structure. You can be asked, better not to wait that you are gone something, that type of questions whose answer you don't know, right? So it's better to understand the whole thing in very clear type. So there must not be even a single question regarding the topic which you are not able to answer. So that's what the reason is, guys, that I focus on maintaining your each and every notes very perfectly. And that's why I used to cover the topic 2 or 3 times in 3 videos. Like single topic, I used to repeat for you in different manner, because some children understand different types of manners and way of teaching. So that's what the reason. Sometimes I teach you through notes, sometimes I use diagrams, sometimes I just made diagrams during the video. So that's what the reason is, that I wanted to clear all the topics in your mind and to answer perfectly in your exam. So that last part that I was talking about, guys, that is the presence between your large intestine and anal is your rectum and anal canal. So that rectum is a place where your waste material is stored. It means it is not necessary that if your body produces your waste material at the time of X, so it is removed from time of X. There is something called as self-alarm, right? So that self-alarm acts according to you have maintained your body form, right? So that's the reason where your waste materials are stored, and from there they cannot damage your body, right? So this is the rectum area where your waste materials are stored. So guys, this was all about your digestive system, and I hope you guys understand it very well.
So that's all guys for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. So we'll meet in the